In this lesson, we're going to take a look at how we can add a curved roof by extrusion in Autodesk Revit. To begin with, I have four walls here, and if I switch to the east elevation, I can see that I have a roof level right at the top of these walls. This is where my roof is going to go. I'll begin by going to the Architecture tab in the Build panel, selecting the drop-down under Roof, and selecting Roof by Extrusion. That will open up the Work Plane dialog box. I have to specify where I'm going to be sketching my shape to be extruded. I can use a named plane if I have any, or I can pick a plane. So I'll select that option, then click OK. Then I'm just going to click this wall out here on the east side of my building. It's going to put it on the roof level, and I'm not going to have an offset, so I'll click OK. I'm now ready to sketch the profile. I'm going to switch to the east elevation view to make that a little bit easier. On this roof, I want 2-foot overhangs, and I find it kind of difficult to get a 2-foot overhang from the outside of the wall by default. It keeps going to the center. So for that reason, I'm going to go ahead and draw in my overhangs. But when I'm ready to finish my roof, I will come back and erase these lines. Next, I'll choose some arc options. So I'll just select the 3-point arc. And I'll create a couple of points here and an arc. And I'll add in some tangent arcs from there. And ultimately, I'll come back to that original endpoint there. Then, as I said, I'm going to delete these lines that I created for the overhangs. I'll select Finish. I can adjust the Rafter Cut. I'll switch to a 2-cut plumb. I'm going to switch back to 3D now, and I'm going to select all of my walls, select Attach Top Base, then select my roof. The last thing I want to do here is fix my overhangs. I have the 2-foot overhangs on the sides, but I don't have any overhangs on the surface where I made my sketch and on the back end. So I'm going to select my roof. The walls were 50 feet long, so I'm going to adjust my extrusion start to a positive 2 feet, which will bring it out in this direction. And then I will change my end to a negative 52 feet to add 2 feet onto that back end as well. That concludes this look at creating a curved roof by extrusion in Autodesk Revit.